Is a live-action historical drama TV series about the Crusades, created by Real Crusades History. At last, Saladin, Richard the Lionheart, and all the glory of the Crusades era in an historically accurate TV series. To learn more, visit KnightsOfTheCross.com and pledge your help to the TV show today. Learn about how you can be in the show yourself.
Hi, and welcome to Stories of the Saints. On July 31st, we celebrate the feast day of Saint Ignatius of Loyola. This story of the saint was on his way to military fame and fortune until a cannonball shattered his leg. Because there were no books or romance books on hand during his recovery, Ignatius wasted the time reading a life of Christ and the lives of the saints. His conscience was deeply touched, and a long, painful turning to Christianity began. Having seen the Mother of God in a vision, he made a pilgrimage to her shrine near Barcelona. He stayed in Spain for almost a year and sometimes spent time with the Dominicans in a hospice, or often in a cave in the hills of Spain praying. It was during this year of the conversion that Ignatius began to write down material that later became his greatest work in the spiritual exercises. He finally achieved his purpose on going to the Holy Land, but could not remain in the city because of the hostility of the Turks. Ignatius spent the next 11 years in various European universities, studying with great difficulty, being almost as a child. Like many others, his orthodoxy was questioned, and Ignatius was twice jailed for some brief periods. In 1534, at the age of 43, he and six other friends vowed to live in poverty and chastity and to go to the Holy Land. If this became impossible, they vowed to offer themselves to the apostolic service of the Pope. The latter became the only choice. 4 years later, Ignatius made the position to be permanent. The new Society of Jesus was approved by Pope Paul III, and Ignatius was elected to serve as the first general. When companions were sent on various missions by the Pope, Ignatius remained in Rome, consolidating his new ventures, but still finding time to give homes for orphans, and later founded the Roman College that was intended to be the model of all other colleges in today's modern society. Ignatius was living life as a true mystic. He centered his spirituality on the essential foundations of Christianity, the Trinity, Christ, and the Eucharist. And his faith was expressed for the greater glory of God. And all of his activities was to be guided by a true love of the church and unconditional obedience to the Holy Father, for which all professed members took a vow to go wherever the Pope should send them for the salvation of souls. If you like this video about Saint Ignatius of Loyola, please press the like button. And if you'd like to learn more about the saints, please feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you want to become a premium member and watch cinematic movies about the saints, just go to thechristianchannel.com and support us by subscribing to our yearly streaming service on your smart TV. Thank you for watching, and God bless.